Hi there, a quick follow-up on the previous video on the PLJ8 LED. If you recall, I got two of them, and on the one with a green 7-segment display I could not adjust the oscillator down enough so it would always read frequencies lower than they were, not by much, about 4 to 5 Hz too low on a 10 MHz input, but still annoyingly wrong. Especially since the second module with a blue display was easy to adjust. At that time I proceeded with a blue display module and kind of abandoned the green one. But it's also annoying to have this module lying around not working correctly, so I decided to have a closer look to see if I could fix it somehow. As I could not find any schematics on that part of the PLJ8 LED module, I started by reverse engineering the 13 MHz oscillator circuit. On the left you see the oscillator portion of the PCB, and on the right my schematic diagram, which I arranged to match the orientation of the actual components. So we have the actual voltage controlled oscillator here, and two sets of resistor capacitor combinations here, and here, and of course the trim pot to adjust the control voltage and thus the frequency of the oscillator. The whole circuit is fed by 3.3 volts produced by this small regulator, an XC6206, out of the 5 volts from the big regulator. The whole circuitry is identical to the blue LED module except for the oscillator. The green LED module uses a TXC instead of the PC53. The problem is that somehow the control voltage is slightly too high, so the oscillator is a few hertz above 13 MHz. Initially I suspected the XC6206 voltage regulator because I measured its output as 3.6 volts. I even got a replacement ready, but a second check revealed a measurement mistake. Its voltage is 3.3 volts as it should. To be able to zoom in to show what I'm measuring while showing the results, I popped the module up on top of the multimeter. Here we have the input voltage from the bench power supply after the polarity protection diode dropping a bit of the 9 volts. And 5.3 on the output of the regulator, which is a bit on the high side but still okay. The output of the XC6206, 3.3 volts. The control voltage of the oscillator is hard to probe. Let's call it 1.152 volts. Which is of course the same as on the 47K resistor. And 2.142 volts after the 39K resistor. Which is of course the same as on the trim pot since they are connected. The other side of the trim pot is at the 3.3 volt rail, as is the wiper. So the trim pot is at its maximum in this configuration, and the control voltage at 1.152 volts is still a little too high. What can be done? As you can see, this is a simple voltage divider, and to reduce the oscillator control voltage we could increase the resistance here by changing the trim pot to one with a higher resistance or increasing the 39K resistor. In either case it will involve desoldering of components, always messy and tricky. Luckily in this location the other side of the PCB is empty, so at least there's no danger of accidentally desoldering things on the reverse PCB side while using a heat gun. But we can avoid all this trouble because the other way to lower the control voltage is to reduce the 47K resistor, and that can be done very easily by adding a parallel resistor. I figured we need to lower the value only a little, so as a test I selected a 100K resistor. 100K in parallel with 47K results to about 32K. Here is a 100K resistor, one end connected to ground, and I'm going to poke the other end on the 47K resistor where the control voltage is taken off. It's a bit of a delicate operation, and the target is really tiny. Sorry, I went out of camera view here. Hey, look at that, 34 Hz above 10 MHz. So the oscillator frequency with the TrimPod at max is now lower than 13 MHz, but the question is, can it be raised sufficiently with the TrimPod? To find out, I need to change the TrimPod to a more middle position. It's a bit hard to read, but the last two digits of the counter are now down from 96 to 39. I'm poking the 100K resistor in. Raises that to just 9.99981. So even with the resistor, the TrimPod still allows the oscillator frequency to be adjusted comfortably to values above and below 13 MHz. Let's see if I can get a bit closer by adjusting the TrimPod to a slightly higher value. So instead of 39, the last digits are now 61. Let's see what happens when applying the 100K resistor. Look at that, almost spot on. Now all that's needed is soldering the 100K resistor in place and then a tiny adjustment. The resistor is in place and no, I did not have an SMD version. And I don't know if you could actually stack SMD resistors to make them parallel. But this botch seems to hold well enough. I have to be a bit careful when resting the device with the display side up, but the resistor is still within the clearance provided by the feed of the module. With the 100K resistor in place, it's time for the fine adjustment. Apologies, I wandered again out of shot. But here it is, 10 MHz with the usual plus minus 1 Hz fluctuation. And if you're interested, the new oscillator control voltage with the fix is now 1.124 volts. The additional resistor dropped the control voltage range sufficiently to allow me to use the TrimPod to get a voltage of 1.124 volts, which is 28 millivolts lower than the previous lowest selectable value. With that change, this particular TXC branded oscillator now runs on exactly 13 MHz, which is needed for accurate measurements of the counter. I thought it would be interesting to compare the two counters after the fix, as you see here, and I noticed a significant difference in the warm-up behavior between the two, which I unfortunately did not catch on camera. So let's get them cooled down again for half an hour to repeat the test. You see both counters and a stopwatch to roughly indicate the time since power on. The blue counter is almost immediately on the right frequency and drifts very little, while the green one is quite a bit off. Initially, I even thought my resistor patch had come loose and was back to the previous behavior. About 3.5 minutes later, the green counter reading has increased and is now approaching the right value. Around 6 minutes after power on, and the counters are very close now. I leave it running for longer to see if the green counter drifts stabilizes. 23 minutes and the counters are now more or less in sync and stable. So apart from not being adjustable to the right frequency without a patch, the TXC oscillator seems to take 10 minutes or so before settling down to a stable frequency. Who knows if that oscillator is genuine? As I said, I could not find a datasheet, but then the same is true for the oscillator in the other counter, which behaves much better. It's probably down to luck on what you get when buying a PLJ8 LED module, and in a sense, having two, probably from both ends of the quality spectrum, made this little project much more interesting for me. Thanks for watching.